Hello badminton fans and welcome to racket test number 715. This is the Jnice elastic air 73. So who are we and what do we do? We test badminton equipment like strings, shuttlecocks, shoes, and of course lots of rackets. Over 750 in actual fact rackets tested on our site in great detail like you've never seen before. If you go to our website and go onto the E-Zone, you can sign in and see all this information for free. You can also advertise your club for free, and you can also advertise any forthcoming tournaments for free. We do ask of you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, subscribe to our website, press the like button, and if you can afford it, please do donate whatever you can so we can keep our work going forward. Thank you. The availability is via our website. £90 is the price. Don't be put off by that price. These rackets are more than worth that money. In actual fact, you know, if they were £140, we'd still be recommending them. Really, really worth it. Manufactured to the highest of quality. It's really worth that sort of money. I don't think you can buy the rackets anywhere else that we know of. You should be aware that there are some places that sell the Black Panther by Jnice. They sell it quite cheap. We spoke to Jnice about this, and it's because Jnice make two versions of the Black Panther. One is a 46 ton carbon racket and one is a 30 ton carbon racket. The 46 ton is the one that we sell. It's the higher end top spec racket. We don't do the lesser material version just because I don't really see the point. So they're the ones that we sell. So again, on our website, available right now, if you press the link below in the comments, or if you go to our website into the E-Zone, you can also do it or do a search on Google. Right, in terms of the spec of this racket, manufacturer spec is a 6U racket. 6U is obviously super duper light, head heavy balance. Most of these light rackets are balanced towards the head. The staff is rated, the shaft even is rated as stiff. The grip size on this, we have it listed as a G6 grip, and a maximum string tension 28 pounds. And this particular racket, I have it written here that it's innovated by Jnice in Taiwan, but I believe that the elastic air, unlike the Black Panther, is made in China, not in Taiwan. That's what information I have here in front of me. Just want to see if there's anything on the racket that will verify any of that, but it doesn't actually say on here that I can see anywhere right now. But we've had many people buy this racket based on the E-Zone scoring. Have a look on your racket and let us know in comments if it says on your racket where it's made. Okay, the E-Zone specs on this racket, it weighed in at 79.2 grams. That is super, super light. Head heavy at 308, so definitely bearing towards the head, the balance of the racket. It has a medium flex shaft, not overly stiff as Jnice are suggesting. It has a medium flex shaft. Now, in terms of the design, well, it's actually really, really well executed, very well made design. All of the, everything they've done here is done really, really well. There's nothing to complain about. Executed beautifully. It's like a white and matte gold combination. Nice detailing. Looks like it's manufactured to a really high quality, no less than Goose and Victor or anyone else. Take a look at these pictures and see what you think for yourself. So what's this racket like to play with? Well, I can tell you it feels super light and really, really agile. It feels really, really quick. It feels medium stiff to play with, not too flexible, not too stiff either. And it feels quick in the air. It is fast. And let me tell you one other thing about this racket. This is the one of the, if not the highest scoring racket in the E-Zone testing out of all the 750 rackets that we've tested. Let that be a testament to how good Jnice actually are. Going through the shots individually, switching screens for you here. We have got it performing really, really well in almost all areas. So repulsion, really good. Drive power, really good. Defensively speaking, it's not bad. Defensive is the only area that I was surprised that it was a little bit slower than we thought. Other than that, overhead shots, really good. How easy it is to pick up and play with, really, really good too. And control and smash power, all very good. So where does that leave us then? Well, I think as a beginner, I'm not sure if you're going to be able to capture the essence of this racket if your skill set is still developing. You know, you need the techniques, you need the ability to be able to swing a lighter racket at high speed to get the most out of them. If your speed is still building, maybe not. Intermediate players, advanced players, professional players definitely can try this racket if you're into light rackets. If you're a head heavy, super stiff person, this racket clearly is not going to work for you. Don't bother trying it, irrespective of the score it scored in the E zone. It's not going to work out for that kind of player. Singles players, yes. Doubles players, yes. The people who have bought the racket, who have left reviews for the racket, what they've said is that while they are, I think the bite size on the sweet spot, should I say, on the actual head is medium. So it's not easy to always strike with accurate power, but I would say give this racket 2-3 sessions. Understand the time. The timing aspect is so important. If you're always hitting off center, you're not going to get clean shots, you're not going to feel the full power, and you're not going to know how quick you need to be able to rotate to get what you need to get out of this racket. Overall, does anything compare to this racket? Well, obviously it competes directly with the Jnice Black Panther, but they are heavier. So this racket is built for people who love light rackets. They want a racket that's light but it's stable. A racket that's light but has the control. A racket that's light and is not flopping around because of its shaft being too flexible. This is a good racket, can be used by almost all players for all types of games. It's a 100% thumbs up. It's a 100% you must try this racket. It is really, really good if you like lighter, faster rackets. If you're into the heavy stuff, this is not going to be working out too good for you, because it means you're relying on that racket weight to get your repulsion, you're relying on the racket weight to push the shuttle. This is more about your skills and a racket that just responds at super, super fast speeds. That's what this racket is about. If you're going across to the E zone to see the smash and the maneuver shot, all the scoring, and you'll see the score on there and how this racket is performed, you are going to be amazed by that. It's free of charge. All you need to do is sign up, go to the E zone now and do that. Advertise your club on the E-Zone and advertise any tournaments you've arranged, because it's free and we need to promote badminton. We're trying to do our part. We're trying to be part of the community. Help us by advertising your stuff for free. We don't benefit from it. There's nothing in it for us. It's genuinely just a service to the badminton community. Outside of that, share these videos, like these videos, subscribe to our channel, show your support. The E-Zone, the Badminton Racket Review movement is all for the badminton community. It's all for you guys. We're here to serve you guys. And, you know, all we're asking for is some involvement back, some input back from all of you who are taking part in the E-Zone memberships, who are taking part in subscribing to our YouTube channel, comments that we're getting. It's all for you guys. And, you know, we need to grow that. We need to expand that. And we have plans for that during 2021. Outside of that, much love to you all. Thank you for your support. And we will see you on the next video.